The 484th game I played was TNN Motorsports Hardcore TR. I'm still not sure, but I think the TR stands for truck racing, as that's all you do in this game. Right out of the gate, I'm struck by ugly menus and a little worried. Sparse options and weird video calibration options do little to assuage my fears. Time to play something and get it over with. We've got 10 locations to race at, and I think 3 tracks at each location. We only have 2 available to start with, though. We're similarly initially limited in our truck selection. The trucks all seem pretty modeled after real ones, but it looks like Utechnics blew their branding budget on the Nashville Network Motorsports name, so we choose the Scorpion and head on. The lowest pressure option sounds like test track, so we choose that and it's drive time. With the feel for the driving under our thumbs, it's time to try a mode that'll evaluate us, and time to switch over to a time trial to try the Mudslinger, too. The big open course feels a lot faster than the test track, and the exposed cliff makes driving through parts of this track genuinely exciting. Time trial mode seems to continue indefinitely, so let's just skip ahead to our first race. Thank you. Though we switched to the yet unseen Texan track, our race goes well enough as we find ourselves rubber banded into the lead just in time. A lead we maintained just enough of that we won despite crashing into one of the finish line posts. A victory confidently secured, we could continue to grind through arcade mode unlocking tracks. Our victory in Texas earned us another Lone Star State track, but we feel like champions, so it's time for championship mode, and an agonizing choice. Do we stick with our trusty trucks or hop in a hot rod? The rods are hot and the ground is dry, but the air is full of victory as I win the first leg of the championship, but the third lap of my first race illuminated one of the game's problems. The AI seems sometimes hopelessly dumb. A truck had crashed of its own accord and gotten stuck in the level geometry and didn't ever press R1 to try and right itself and spawn back on track. We'll take the wins however they come, though, and it's off to New Mexico for round two. A second place finish in the desert shortens our lead, and it's off to Oregon for race 3, and by now I'm enjoying this game. This proves to be the most fun track I get to play. We'll be right back. The corner before the logging camp fucks us up on every lap, and it's another second place finish and an even more tenuous lead as we head into the mountains of Colorado. Colorado's first track features a big fork in it, and taking what turns out to be the slower easy route just once costs us our lead and we never regain it. We're tied with Firefly, the hot rod yellow van, going into the last race. We're both doing so well that even a second place finish is fine, so long as the loss isn't to the other one.
Thank you.
Stymied on Every Lap by the notorious underpasses of Southern California, a third-place finish means Firefly wins the Amateur Hot Rod Championship comfortably and our try is over. TNN Motorsports Hardcore TR isn't a very good game. It's very generic feeling, and accidentally pressing the button to reset your truck feels terrible when it happens. The AI racing opponents are of questionable verisimilitude and either crash often to accommodate competition with bad players or crash never to accommodate competition with good ones. But said competition does remain fun. Racing feels fast, fair, and responsive. I only ended up seeing a few tracks, but what I saw felt well designed, often flowing well between difficult and easy sections. There seemed to be a fair few available to unlock, too. As the track demo shows, there are a number of flashy, obtainable different trucks, too, and they all definitely have a certain Guy Fieri aesthetic about them, but Guy's alright, and so is this game.